Hey, guys. Hi, Mel. So we've come up with excuses for the last 4 months of why the market was going to correct. At first, it was going to be Turkey. Then it was going to be Brazil. Then it's going to be... Ultimately, what it comes down to is corrections happen when there's excessive optimism and low volatility. We called for this earlier in 2018, right as you were exiting. You had this incredible 7.5% run in January in the first 3 weeks that nobody expected. And bullishness got really high. You got up to over 60% bulls in Investors Intelligence newsletter writers. And I'm kind of finding the same kind of consensus. We've talked about it over recent weeks where you're seeing the same thing where bullish newsletter writers, again, have been over... they're over 60%. That's just too much. There's too many people that are saying pro-U.S. So when you look at that coupled with low volatility, okay, here we are at a historically low level of volatility, the same kind of thing again that we got before that prior move there. And you can see it, volatility happens fast, as Pete and Tim and everybody else is talking about. It happens quickly. Again, there's no way I want to be negative or defensive in a market with a fundamental backdrop we have, but there's periods where you can wait to buy the next tick. And I think if you couple the number of bulls at over 60% of newsletter writers and the historically low volatility, I don't think there's any question we could have a little bit more downside here.
So, and how much more would that be in your view?
It's one of those things. So let's identify where you want to buy instead of how much it could be. I mean, we saw in January, at the end of January, nobody expected a 12% move in about 4 days. So it can happen very quickly because of the structure of the marketplace. Where do you want to actually get more aggressive on the buy side is our main messaging versus a quote unquote level. And it's when you have more than less than 20% of stocks trading above their 10-day moving average has been a good early, I don't want to say warning sign, but an early sign that you're about to bottom out and the market's getting washed out enough. And looking at that VIX that we had up on the screen, anything close to 20 is a pretty good short-term indicator as well.
How far are we away from that?
5 points away on the VIX, okay. And we're, I think, about 5 to 6 points away. Actually, no, about 10 points away on the percentage of stocks above the 10-day. It's in the 30s.
Once you hit that signal and you're in it to buy, what do you buy? Are you just as aggressive as your past positions, or do you change
Absolutely.
The kinds of stocks that you buy?
Absolutely. See, that's the thing that I think I really want to convey is people, when the market goes down, they tend to get cautious more as it goes down. When you're in a backdrop of fundamental earnings, a solid credit backdrop, even though the 10-year yields are rising, you still have money availability. The last thing you want to do is get really negative on a decline.
So, Tony, are you worried about as we get in further into Q4, we obviously have Q3 earnings coming in earnest over the next couple of weeks, that a lot of, like, let's say future growth is kind of priced in here. We're getting to valuation levels. We're getting to peak margins. We're getting to some of these things where what is the upside? You know, I mean, we had this breakout, but we're not maybe able to sustain it. What's the upside into 2019?
The upside is the direction of earnings. So the rate of change of earnings doesn't correlate to anything over time to the S&P price. The only thing that correlates most closely to the S&P 500 is the direction of earnings. And also, if I gave all of you a 25% raise,
that sure would be nice. That, we were waiting for that.
I
love
that time.
It's all yours. I promise I'll pay you that. Anyway, if I gave you a 25% raise, would you spend it all in the first week? There's no way. You're going to hug it a little bit, get comfortable with you have more money in your bank account.
I see Pete spending
it
right away.
Over time.
Get rid
the
of
S&P 500 just got a 25% raise. 26% Q1. 25% Q2, it'll likely be 25% Q3, and it'll be close to 20 to 22% Q4. That's a lot. That's real money. This isn't accounting game.
Yeah, but you're saying that it is an accounting game because, you know, like...
Oh, it's revenue.
No, but listen,
cash.
Apple has been paying 24% taxes for the last 3 years, so it's not the boon that a lot of investors think it is, and then you're talking about the rate of change of EPS growth. It's already factored in at this point.
It's 100% the boom everybody's talking about. You had a 10% increase in the top-line growth rate because of the regulatory...
This year, but we don't see that expectation for next year in 2020.
Again, the market correlates to the direction, not the rate of change. So you could have a correction around a slowing, which, you know, can happen at any time. The question isn't whether there can be a correction. I've talked about this since the Fed started raising rates. You're coming in with higher volatility at times. There's not a question of whether it's going to correct. What do you do with it? And the only time that you want to sell a correction historically in the marketplace is when you have an identifiable recession in sight. That only comes after an inversion of the yield curve, a tightening of lending standards by banks, and increased stress in interbank lending. None of those things are happening. And that's why I think it's so important to not make the mistake. I think it's going to go down a little bit more. Okay, right. I said it in January. It's going to happen. I think it's an opportunity until you have those things I just mentioned in place.
Tony, thanks. Good to see you. Tony Dwyer.
Thanks for having me.
Ingenuity.
Thank you, guys.
What'd you do today, Karen? What would be on your buy list?
What's on my buy list? Alphabet is on my buy list. Got shellac today. Mm-hmm. I'm long banks already. I'm pretty long banks already, so I probably wouldn't buy more. I mean, GM still on my buy list.
What'd you do today, Pete?
Well, I did buy XLF today, and I did because of some options activity that we saw in there, and I did add to the banks. I'll tell you what I like. When you get these kind of spikes in the volatility that Tony's talking about, they've gotten shorter and shorter and shorter, Mel. If you go over the last year, the expansion time of how long they last, where they remain above the 13 level, I want to use that volatility right now in names that I want to hold on to. So in a Microsoft, in an Apple, whatever it might be, implied volatilities are rising. Now I can sell upside calls against those positions. That's what I'm trying to do most.
I got to tell you, I just can't disagree more with like the buy list thing. We're seeing some of the most cyclical groups in the market acting like death. We're seeing home builders act like death. We're seeing autos act like death. We're seeing banks really underperform. We're seeing semiconductors that just turned. We just started to see retail turn here.
That's the same story we've had for the last year. Home builders have been death for a long time. So have autos. So have semis peaked in June. Okay. So, I mean, I mean, you may have been right back then, but I don't know. If you're making a list on
stuff... So where's the leadership come?
Well, I would prefer to actually take your side and point out something different and why I might actually agree with you, but I agree with it more that stuff that I want to find a place to buy is proving to me it's not time. So you've made fresh new lows, relative lows on emerging markets to the S&P. You're now at 8-year lows on EM to the S&P. You're at Germany underperforming the U.S.
Tim, the only reason why the S&P 500 and the NASDAQ are up this year at this point in time is because of 6 stocks that make up a disproportionate amount of the weight. So what I'm saying is there's bear markets going on all over the place and no one's paying attention to it because of the MAGA.